Praise the Lord. I'm so happy to be able to share with you the devotion for today, July 29th. This is a special day because this is the Global Tiger Awareness Day. This day was celebrated first in 2010 when the 13 Tiger Range countries came together to create an awareness about the magnificent tiger and how important it is to save this animal from extinction. I want to say to you today and just let you know that these creatures are indeed magnificent, but they are also dangerous. Many people have lost their lives because they are unaware of the risk of playing with a tiger or being within the vicinity of a tiger, unprepared and unaware. This kind of goes along with our lessons at the beginning of the week, as we're reminded that the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about seeking whom he may devour. You see, one of the tiger attacks that I read about took place when Roy Horn, who was a trainer, lost his life in a tiger attack. Roy Horner was attacked when he was least expecting it. From all accounts, on the night he was attacked, it was just another show. He had done this show over 5,000 times before, but for some unknown reason, he let down his guard. Going through the same old, it just became habitual. And when he was least expecting it, the tiger attacked. We may think that we are just playing around with sin. We're okay with this little thing. We've done it time and time again, and we haven't gotten into trouble. We've heard that, you know, it's dangerous, but no, we've played with this before. We're okay. We can rush back to the altar and repent about it tomorrow. But when we least expect it, just like that tiger, it can leap on us and cause disastrous results. Sin always causes destruction. Sometimes it's a little piece at a time, sometimes it's all at once, but whatever it is, the outcome is always devastation to our soul. Be aware. Stop playing with sin. The tiger struck when Roy Horn was isolated. In other words, when the tiger was being trained, he was in a cage. There were several others close by with Roy as he was handling this tiger. But on the stage, it was just him and this magnificent creature all alone. And the tiger took advantage of that opportunity. We need to make sure that we stay connected to one another, that when we're going through hard times, that we don't isolate ourselves, because what we do is make ourselves a vulnerable prey for the devil's attack. We need to connect with those around us, connect with those in the church, make sure that we spend time in the presence of God, connecting to Him. Don't isolate yourself from your protection, but stay linked with God and the people of God. One of the ways that was put out as a way to prevent a tiger attack was to build a huge fire. So when they're out in the wilderness and they are surrounded by these magnificent beasts and they're doing what they do, they're looking for food, they're looking for prey. One of the things that they are encouraged to do is to build the biggest fire that they can, because the lion, the tiger, hate fire. So if they can build this huge flame and cause it to burn and then get as close as it to they can, they are protecting themselves from an attack. Well, just like in the physical, in the spiritual, we need to do the same thing. We need to make sure that that Holy Ghost fire is burning inside of our soul, and we need to allow it to burn and burn and consume us to protect us from the onslaught of hell. Let the fire of the Holy Ghost burn inside of you. Kindle that flame and let it be one of the biggest ones burning right now. May God bless you today.